Hello, everyone. This is Slade Wilson, a.k.a. Deathstroke. You may have seen me on the news recently. Yes, I was the one who kidnapped Thea Queen. And I'm the guy with the eye patch. But I'm here to tell you now that the folks that live in Starling City, you have nothing to fear. I'm only after one man. Oliver Queen. He was the one who was responsible for the death of my beloved 5 years ago, and I will avenge her. To Oliver Queen, I say this. You cannot die until you know complete despair. And you will. I promise. And after I've taken everything from you, I will drive an arrow through your eye.
God, I've been watching too much Arrow recently. Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Thomas and Friends Home Media Reviews. And before you ask, yes, that entire first segment with me speaking like Slade Wilson was a reference to the TV show Arrow. A couple of plot points were referenced in there. So if you haven't already seen Arrow, I would already recommend you to go ahead and check it out. Season 2 is the best season, and it's my favorite season because it has Slade Wilson, a.k.a. Deathstroke as its main villain, and he is awesome. Anyway, we're not here to talk about Arrow, we are here to talk about Races, Rescues, and Runaways, one of my favorite releases to date. So, let's not waste any more time, let's go ahead and jump right in to the history section of Races, Rescues, and Runaways. So, Races, Rescues, and Runaways was first released in 1999 on VHS, and then was re-released in 2002 on VHS. It was then re-released in 2009 on DVD. And here's something interesting. I've actually seen a Universal printing of this at FYE. I will say it was printed in around 2014, maybe late 2015. So let's move right into the close-up section of my copies of Races, Rescues, and Runaways. Alrighty, everyone. Here's your close-up look at Races, Rescues, and Runaways. Now, technically, we only have one copy to show off here, but we'll get to that in a minute. Alright, let's start with the box artwork. It's Thomas the Tank Engine and Friends, Races, Rescues, and Runaways, another Thomas Adventures. Large picture of Percy, which actually makes sense. And then a picture of Thomas in the barn, which also makes sense because that story is on this release. So already we're starting out with two photos that actually make sense. So that's a step up. There's a new Thomas, which we haven't seen. This Thomas first made his appearance in the Cranky Bugs VHS from 1998, but obviously I didn't have that to show you, so yeah. As you can see, he's that Thomas that's on the back of a lot of tapes, but he also has tracks underneath them. It's very interesting. He will show up again on Spills and Chills. Scrolling on the side here, Britt Allcroft. On the back, you got a photo from Toby and the Flood and Something in the Air. Yeah, storyteller Alec Baldwin, your blur about what's on the tape and such, and your story stops. Here's that quote, entertainment to grow up with. Interesting, and there's that same Thomas that was on the side. Here's your ink label tape. That's right, this is the 1998 box, but I believe that Anchor Bay put this tape out, didn't change the box. They just stuck the ink labels inside of that box, so yeah, this is the ink label for Races, Rescues, and Runaways. It's very basic. It's got that little Thomas behind the bush thing, like some of the other reprints do as well. So yeah, that's not the 1998 VHS version, because it should have a sticker label if it's from 1998. That's a way to differentiate, which also makes the 1998 version somewhat hard to track down since it's in the same box. Like I said, we kind of have another copy to look at. This is the copy I got in that lot, the 6 VHS tape lot. This is actually my childhood copy. Yeah, it's ironic that the tape in the lot is in worse condition than the one from my childhood. It's basically the exact same version. It's a 2002 reprint as well. Just the box is in slightly crappier shape, but you know, it's a nice second copy in case I ever need to replace this one. So yeah, that's your close-up look at Races, Rescues, and Runaways. Now let's go ahead and head on back and answer the 5 main questions as always. All right, so we're back from the close-up, and now it's time to answer the 5 main questions as always. Number one, where can you pick this product up? Same answers as pretty much all the other episodes in this series, pretty much. Number two, is this product still being printed nowadays? For the first time, we can finally answer yes to this question because I have confirmed that yes, there is a universal printing of this. I believe, as I said in the history section, maybe late 2015, early 2016. But yes, I can finally answer yes to this question. You know, you'll have no idea how happy I am about this. It took, what, 20 episodes for us to find something that's still being printed nowadays? Gosh. Number three, should you pick this product up? Abso-freaking-lutely. The stories on this release are brilliant. The stunts are brilliant with the models, and it's just a great release all around. Number four, where should you pick this product up? Same answers as number one. And number five, what price should you pay? Like I said in the history section, I didn't pick up that 2015, 2016 print because it was a bit overpriced, because I feel that you shouldn't pay over $5 for any of these. For the 1999 VHS version, though, that's a bit more rare because it is a sticker label, and I would say you could probably go up 10, maybe 15 in rare circumstances for that release. So that's my home media review on Races, Rescues, and Runaways. And guys, I cannot believe that I'm saying this, but our next episode is on 10 years of Thomas. We have gone through 10 years of VHS releases in America. How crazy is that? It took me, what, almost a year or over a year to get to this point, and now we have gone through 10 years of releases and 10 years of Thomas in America. That's crazy. Anyway, that's our next episode, so I will catch you all next time, and as always, good night, everybody.